come back to the topic, principles of inheritance and variation. In this video, we will discuss important concept, that is linkage. After the proposal of chromosomal theory of inheritance, many scientists started conducting different experiments to confirm the same. Amongst many scientists, Thomas Hunt Morgan, who is said to be father of experimental genetics, with his colleagues discovered the basis for the variation, and he, to explain variation, conducted experiments on the organism by name Drosophila melanogaster. Drosophila melanogaster is a common fruit fly and it is called Cinderella of the genetics. Now, the question for 3 marks can be asked as, what made Thomas Hunt Morgan to select Drosophila? The reasons are as follows. The first reason is Drosophila could be grown on a simple synthetic medium in the laboratory. We can easily culture the Drosophila by using artificial medium. If we don't have any of the artificial medium, a small banana in a glass jar will be enough for the culture of the Drosophila. The second reason is the Drosophila complete its life cycle in about 2 weeks. Within 2 weeks, it's going to cross all the phases of the lifespan. So it becomes very easy for us to study the different characters, the variation. So that made T.H. Morgan to select Drosophila. The third reason is only single mating between the male and female will make the female to give or to lay many eggs. So large number of progenies we are going to obtain as a result of only one mating. So we'll have many Drosophilas for the study. So that made Morgan to select the Drosophila. Then the fourth reason, Drosophila is with clear differentiation of the sexes. The male and female can be easily identified and can be easily differentiable. So that's why that becomes another reason for the selection of the Drosophila. Drosophila is with many types of hereditary variations. Okay, it is with many variations like white tie, yellow body and miniature wing. About all these things we are going to study in the same module, and those can be seen easily with low power of the microscope. So all these 5 reasons, the 5 characters of the Drosophila made Thomas Hunt Morgan to select Drosophila. So let's try to understand how the linkage concept was explained. Though linkage and recombination was experimentally proved by Thomas Hunt Morgan, but the concept of linkage was explained by 2 scientists, and they are Bateson and Punnett. Bateson and Punnett performed dihybrid cross between plants with characters like blue flower, long pollen with a white flower and a short pollen. This character they selected from the sweet pea plant, okay? And Bateson Punnett were expecting in the F2 ratio 9:3:3:1, because this is a dihybrid cross, but instead they got a different ratio. Just for curiosity, they conducted a test cross, and in the test cross the ratio should be 1:1:1:1, but they got the ratio 7:1:1:7. So this made Bateson and Punnett to think, and they said that the parental character, the first 7 and the last 7 in the 7:1:1:7 are parental characters. They are getting inherited, that is their percentage of occurrence is more. Why? They were not able to explain. Later, Thomas Hunt Morgan conducted experiments on the Drosophila melanogaster, and he was a person who put forth a theory called linkage and recombination. So let's try to understand the meaning of the linkage. Linkage is said to be tendency of the genes to get inherited together. So if the genes are always getting inherited together without getting separated, then that is called as linkage. Let's take an example of a pea seed only. where we did a cross between round yellow and wrinkled green. And if we see the gamete formation, round yellow and wrinkled green, okay, and they were getting inherited. And if we see the ratio, phenotype ratio 9:3:3:1, 9+1, that is 10, are parental type. So parental characters always tend to get inherited together. So if the genes are getting inherited together, then it is called as linkage. Then what about the next one? That is recombination. Recombination is expression of non-parental traits or characters in the offspring, like round green and wrinkled yellow in the pea plant. So those arise due to the crossing over. So this was explained by Thomas Hunt Morgan. Okay, now let us try to understand types of the linkage. So first of all, we'll try to understand the meaning. Tendency of two or more genes to remain together in original combination during inheritance. That is, two to more genes will remain together. Okay, then it is called as linkage. Linked genes, according to T.H. Morgan, will be situated close to each other. So that's why they never will get separate from each other. So if the genes never get separate from each other, then that forms a type of a linkage called complete linkage. Now, the example for the complete linkage is Y chromosome of the Drosophila. It never undergoes a crossing over. The genes present on the Y chromosome are said to be completely linked, whereas these genes are said to do not separate, they'll not separate, and they get inherited together. Linked genes, if they are located distantly, bit away from each other, then they may undergo crossing over, and that may lead to incomplete linkage. So for example, in the sweet pea, blue flower color and long pollen and white flower with a short pollen, that was a cross which was conducted by Bateson and Punnett, and they actually gave the idea of a linkage, if you remember. So this example is a one which shows the incomplete linkage, because of which they got 7:1:1:7 as a test cross ratio. So these genes which are distantly located on the chromosome may get separate by process called as crossing over. Now, let's try to understand Morgan's experiment. Morgan conducted experiment by using Drosophila melanogaster so as to explain linkage and recombination. He conducted a dihybrid cross in the Drosophila. Genes that were linked were not getting separated independently from each other. And in the F2, the ratio 9:3:3:1 became different. It got deviated. So what made the ratio to get changed? Let's try to understand that. When two genes in dihybrid cross are situated on the same chromosome, if the genes are situated on the same chromosome, then what will happen? The parental gene combinations were appearing much higher than the non-parental type. If the distance between the genes are less, then the parental combinations will appear more, and non-parental type appear if the distance between the genes is not close to each other. So if the distance is not much higher, then they undergo crossing over, and that result into recombination, and the genes are called recombinant. So Morgan explained this as the physical association of the linkage, that is gene, that is the distance between the gene is responsible for the linkage. Okay, the ratio varies due to the distance between the gene. So let's see how the ratio varies. The distance between three genes are considered to understand. The first gene is the gene for eye color, that is white eye, as you can see in the diagram there, and yellow body with a miniature wing. So this is a mutant Drosophila. Normal Drosophila will have brown body, red eye, and a normal wing. The Drosophila which has undergone mutation is with white eye, yellow body, and miniature wing. So now the percentage of this gene appearance will be compared. So we are going to determine the linkage by taking the parental and recombinant type percentage. How much percentage of parental type will appear in F2 and how much percentage of recombinant types will appear in F2. So based on that we are going to explain linkage and recombination. So let's try to take an example. So in the given slide there is a cross A. It is taken directly from NCERT. Okay, and if you go to F2 generation, there you can see parental type and recombinant type. So if two organisms are crossed and if the genes between the distance between the gene is very less, then the recombinant types will appear to only 1.3%. That is highlighted one, you can see. The adjacent side, if you see the parental type, it is appearing 98.7%. Okay, students, you need not practice drawing all these things. You should remember how much percentage of parental type is appearing in F2 and how much percentage of recombinant. Let me show you the recombinant type here. White eye and yellow body genes were tightly linked and showed only 1.3% of a recombination, whereas in the cross B, if you see once again, recombinant is appearing only to 37.2%, whereas parental type is 62.8%. So if we see both the examples, the parental characters are getting inherited together compared to recombinant type. So parental type is because of linkage and recombinant type is because of the recombination. So in both the cases, the parental types were higher than the recombination. So in this video, we understood the meaning of the linkage, types of the linkage, and one example for the linkage. Whereas in the next video, we are going to understand another example for the linkage by taking Drosophila. Thank you, students.